potentially, if we can get all this to work, we'll be the first Australian gold producer to produce net zero gold.
Hello and welcome back to the Proactive Studio. I'm Tylah Tully, and joining me today is OzAurum Resources Managing Director and CEO Andrew Pumphrey to talk us through the latest developments from its Mulgabbie North Gold Project, where it signed an agreement with Lion Hydrogen and BIM Metals to complete the project's Heap Leach feasibility study. Andrew, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks very much, Tyler, for the opportunity to speak with you this morning.
So, talk to us about this agreement. How does it work, and what are the terms?
Oh, look, it's a really exciting development for us because it's going to give us a potential to get into gold production. So the agreement with Lion Hydrogen and BIM Metals is all about completing the feasibility study. So we've done a lot of works in the sort of background, probably even when I was in Brazil for the last 12 months, we've been doing ticking away at it slowly. But now Brendan will bring that up to the next level. And basically, we need to get it to the point that we can basically fund the project. So the work he's going to be doing will be more detailed work of what we've already done. So, and the beauty of it is it's fully funded by Lion Hydrogen and BIM Metals. And after we get through the feasibility study, we'll be also looking at raising, or he'll get a debt facility to get this mine into production. So I guess there's a lot of permitting stuff that we need to do in the background. So it's going to be a really busy 12 months for us to get through this study and then get to the next stage. So it's a really exciting development for OzAurum.
Yeah, so could you expand a bit further? What's the strategic advantage for the company?
Oh, look, for all junior explorers, we're all in the same boat. It's always, it's fantastic, we've found this resource, but now we've got to monetize it for our shareholders. So the next step is, well, how do we do that? So, I've run a whole series of mine optimizations over the last probably 18 months, 2 years, looking at all the various scenarios. Do we mine it and mill it through our conventional CIP mill? Do we truck it all the way back into Kalgoorlie? Do we process it on site? How are we going to do this? So, like for us, the heap leaches, would be based on site, and it gives us the ability to get into production, and we're free carried of all the costs. So one of the biggest issues with juniors is actually getting the capital to get these things, up and running. It's a lot of money. So with Brendan on board, and he's got a background in banking as well as metallurgy. So yeah, he's going to, being able to fund it is the biggest issue without diluting our shareholders at all. So I think it's a really exciting development. And Brendan's a perfect partner. I worked with him on a heap leach feasibility study for about 12 months, a number of years ago, so I know him quite well. He's probably the leader in heap leaching in Australia. I mean, he's done a lot of it privately. He's a hydrometallurgist by qualification. He's worked with Rio Tinto for a long time and Straits Resources, so he's a gun in this heap leaching. So I just couldn't think of a better partner to bring on board, as well as he's also operated a private mining contracting fleet. So he's he covers all facets of the operation. So I thought he was ideally matched for us to sort of work with going forward on this and get this project into development.
And Lion Hydrogen is looking to produce net zero gold. Can you talk to us about this and how big it is, not only for OzAurum, but also Australia?
Oh, look, I'm really excited about that. And when Brendan first mentioned it, I just thought this is fantastic. Potentially, if we can get all this to work, we'll be the first Australian gold producer to produce net zero gold. And the way the hydrogen works is that it actually is going to replace the diesel that normally be used on site. And obviously, there's all the emissions around that. So, and look, we're not going to let this hold our progress up. I mean, if we have to, we'll start on a diesel fleet and then move over to hydrogen. But ideally, it'd be great to start on hydrogen straight up. So being able to produce net zero gold, we may even find we might get a premium for our gold. So I will be looking at all aspects of all our emissions on site regarding this. So everything that would normally be diesel powered would be powered by hydrogen. And the beauty about their hydrogen technology is amazing at the moment. I did a lot of research on this before I obviously went into this with Brendan. And, all through Europe, they've got hydrogen plants, which basically, you get water and you produce hydrogen and oxygen. I mean, there's zero emissions from it. And Cummins have actually built the first diesel engines in the world that are run solely off hydrogen. But actually, hydrogen can be added into an existing fuel diesel engine fairly easy as a sort of as a ratio to get them started. So, look, there's a lot in that technology. So we're really just excited to be part of it. So yeah, it's really really great.
It sounds really exciting. Looking to the project, can you talk us through the Mulgabbie North project? And I understand you've got some new exploration targets.
Oh, look, absolutely. Look, we've worked on this. We floated or IPO'd this company on OzAurum was IPO'd on Mulgabbie North. Look, we did a lot of drilling on it. We did over 80 or 90,000 metres of drilling out there. And because we weren't getting much love from the market, there's a whole stack of targets still sitting there that I haven't been able to follow up, mainly because of the whole gold sector has been going through this sort of a downturn that now we're seeing is changing. So some of those targets were generated from our seismic interpretation that we did redid over the area. So where these new cross faults are, and we know of all the major mines in that area, including all the Northern Star ones across the fence, that wherever a cross fault goes through the prospective stratigraphy, you're going to find a mine. So we'll find a resource that'll turn into a mine. So all the major mines on their side of the fence have a cross fault associated with them. And we've got two of these cross faults that we haven't explored properly. But we've got some excellent RC hits on it. I mean, they're walk-up targets. So when the time's right, we'll get back out there and keep drilling on them and hopefully, make a really significant discovery there.
So, looking to the macro environment now, as you know, gold price reached record highs last week. How are you positioned to capitalize on this? And can you talk us through the gold market outlook?
Oh, look, I'm no expert on the gold market, but on the if we potentially getting into production, obviously it gets us to the point where we can produce ounces of gold and make a profit for our shareholders. So that's number one. I can't see this gold price winding back in a hurry. So I think it's only going to go up. And there's a lot of commentators saying the same. So look, I think it's a really exciting time. I mean, I've been in the business now for a long time, for over 30 years. I clearly remember it was $200 an ounce, and we didn't get any love from anyone. The whole gold thing has been completely, in the last sort of 5 years, just, we've been wiped out virtually. So it's now nice to see gold's finally having its time in the sun. So, and look, it's unfortunate that it's on the back of all this world, I guess, but the issues are going on at the moment with Russia and terrible events happening everywhere, unfortunately. But I guess there's all the gold, these gold producers are all making good margins at the moment. So I'm just hopeful gold price keeps staying up, which I think it will. So,
So, what are the next steps?
well, Tylah, we'll get stuck into this feasible, Brendan will get stuck into this feasibility study. He'll hit the ground running, obviously, assist him as much as I can. We'll continue to work up these gold targets, and I'd like to see us out there drilling some of them. So that'll be on the radar sort of in the near future, hopefully. So yeah, exciting times.
Definitely very exciting times for the company. We hope to continue to hear all about it. Thanks so much for your time today.
Yeah, thanks very much, Tylie. Have a good day.